Danielle, so lovely to see you.
Lovely to see you too.
And I always love catching up with you when you've got new music because you have such a special sound. But this amazing first single, Small Town Boy, you've taken a Bronski beat here, Jimmy Somerville hit that we all know, and you've turned it on its head. It's fantastic. Why did you pick this song?
This is a collaboration between myself and Vince Pazinga, who is somebody that I did my first album with. He produced that. And when we were deciding on songs for this album, that was like a no-brainer for both of us. We were focusing on songs from the 80s because that's when we were growing up. And I just think it's a really interesting track. It just has that great pop sensibility, but it had quite a deep message. Wouldn't it be good to
be in your shoes? What does the 80s represent for you?
Oh, represents my teenage years and going out to clubs and discovering music and discovering artists and all of that. And Vince and I are around the same age, so that is our era of musical influences that kind of stayed with us through the rest of our musical lives, I guess.
Now you've called the album Lost Luggage. Why?
Well, I've got to come clean on that, Ange. That is not my idea. That was Tennyson. That was my youngest son, who's now 14.
Wow.
Not so young. And Vince and I were throwing around names for the album, and Tenny walked in and he goes, "How about Lost Luggage?" And Vince went, "I like that. It's like luggage from your past, music from your past, things that you've sort of lost along the way and then bringing them back to have a look at them." So I've got to give the credit to Tenny.
You have to give him 10%? Has he demanded a cut?
Yeah.
Yeah.
15.
15? Yeah. I like his work already. It doesn't hurt me. Do you want to feel how it feels? So tell us some of the other songs that are on the album. What other gems have you picked out?
We have done a Kate Bush song, Running Up That Hill.
How good is that song? I love that song.
Love that song. That is an absolute classic. George Michael, Careless Whisper. New Order, True Faith. A Eurythmics song, Who's That Girl? And a Nick Kershaw song, Wouldn't It Be Good?
Wow. Taking on Kate Bush as always.
Ridiculous, really.
No,
I don't
ridiculous.
Even know why I shouldn't have, but it's just it's a salute to Kate. It's just respect, and she's an amazing artist, and it was fun just reimagining those songs. I'm never going to do them better than the original artists. It's just doing them differently and kind of turning them on their heads a bit. I used to think that the
day you would never. When you were putting the album together and planning it, were you picturing that you would be touring?
Yeah, we were actually talking about how we'll get a cellist and we'll get a string player and we'll get a this and a that and trying to think of the setup on stage, but none of that is happening, and obviously that's not happening for any musicians at the moment. So it's challenging to kind of get it out there, but I guess social media and all of that, that helps you to kind of keep pushing it out. But yeah, disappointing that we can't actually take it on the road at this point. Who's that girl
running around with you? I'm imagining at the time you were recording, did it coincide with the boys being home and lockdown? And
we had actually finished by then, and in this lockdown period I have written a solo album, so I've done a bunch of originals. I had started it just before lockdown, but I've finished that now, so I'm about to start going into the studio to record that.
Wow.
So it's been a strange period of time for all of us.
Do you think we're going to be in the artistic world having an amazingly fruitful amount of product from this time?
I do, actually. Isolation is what we do. We lock ourselves in a room and we write songs and you're on your own. And without all the other distractions of having to run kids around and do all of that, you sort of end up with a lot more time to create.
Did you feel there was enough support for artists during this time, or did they get a bit left out in the cold?
It's a really difficult area. I understand that, and I understand for governments it's difficult to know where to draw the line, but it's particularly tough for people that rely on gigging to survive and rely on touring to kind of feed their family. And I think a lot of the time people assume that artists are more wealthy than they are. they'd sort of think, well, they're high profile, I'm seeing them on TV, they'll be all right. They don't realise that, especially in somewhere like Australia, the pay is not very high for theatre workers and people on TV. So I think it, you know, it's tough.
A lot of people are focusing on what are going to be the possible mental health ramifications from this lockdown. Now, your dad has a wonderful charity, the Australian Children's Music Foundation, and I know you're very passionate about it too. It is a specially healing thing, isn't it?
It really is. And the ACMF at the moment are following up on children that have been affected by all of this. They're still dealing with the kids that were affected by the fires. But then straight off the back of that came COVID. Music is incredibly healing. There are so many stories of kids that have just had their lives turned around, that don't have parents that are present, but they find their family with these teachers that are teaching them music, and the other kids that are forming bands with them. They're writing songs, they're recording songs, and they kind of find a new lease of life. If I only could,
I'd make a deal with God. So you've got another new album ready to record. Is that going to be Danielle's Christmas album? Is it going to be And by that I don't mean Jingle Bells and the full songs. And the full buble.
I'd like to do that at some point. I love that buble Christmas album.
I do too. He does it so well.
He does. I don't know. I'm going to start recording and I'll see, you know, how things are feeling. Again, you know, it's this thing with music where you want to be able to go out and perform it and get out there a little bit. I'm hoping to have a song out fairly soon and the album out not too much after.
And you did that spectacular fashion shoot for Stella magazine.
Oh, thank you. That was hot.
Is that fun too? Do you love doing a bit of fashion?
It's easy when you've got a wonderful team around you.
But they take you out of your comfort zone. I figure I've got a look or whatever that I'm comfortable in, and then you go in and look at all the clothes I've been and go,
Yes.
But they know what they're doing.
Yeah. The first thing I was shown was, this is what we want for the cover. And I went, oh, and she goes, it's a dress, but it was a top. And I went,
but you got the legs.
I went, okay. Popped it on, it's pretty short. But they shoot it so well. It was a really fun day.
I hadn't even thought about that Bronski Beat song in such a long time about Small Town Boy. It is a truly great song.
It is a really great song,
You bring it to life in a really special way, so
Thank
I love it.
Thank you very much, Angela. That's lovely.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too.
Danielle's album, Lost Luggage, is out now.